Hello boys and girls, today we are going to make a foam black print. The first thing we need to do is get our foam. It's a thin sheet of styrofoam, and you don't want to bend it or fold it because it will break pretty easily. The best tool to make our design on this foam block is a dull pencil. So if you could find a pencil that's not too sharp, that would be a great choice for this project. What I'm going to do is draw my design onto the foam directly. Now there's fancier ways of drawing your picture on another piece of paper and then transferring it, but today we're gonna keep it super, super simple. So what I'm gonna do is just very carefully draw my design, and I'm pressing pretty hard when I do this. I really wanna press down hard into the foam. And then I'm adding details and small designs and patterns just to make it really interesting. When you do this, if your pencil starts to go all the way through the foam, please stop and just kind of check yourself. You might be pressing a little bit too hard, or maybe your pencil is a little too sharp and it's actually cutting through all the way. When you're done, you should be able to feel it with your finger. So if you run your finger over all of the lines you made, you should be able to feel the indentation. Also, please make sure when you do this that you don't try to erase. If you make a mistake, you're going to have to make your mistake part of your drawing. You can't get rid of it by erasing it, so don't take an eraser and rub it on your foam. When you're done, you should be able to see your design indented into your foam. The next thing we're going to do is take a plastic tray and put a little bit of ink on the tray. This kind of ink is called black printing ink. We just need a little bit of that ink on there, a couple inches of ink. And then I'm going to take my brayer and pushing all the ink down to one end so it's in a little puddle at the end. And then I'm going to take my brayer and roll my ink out, going in one direction at a time. So I'm going forward, lifting my brayer up, forward, up, forward, up, forward, up. And when you do that, you get a much more even layer of ink. You don't want too much. That's why I want that puddle to stay at the end, because most of my ink is going to be for later. So you really don't want all of it spread out right away. When your whole brayer is covered with an even layer of ink, and it sounds like Velcro, you're going to roll that ink onto your block. And I like to put a piece of paper underneath so it doesn't get all over the table. You may probably want to go back and load your brayer up a couple more times till you hear that Velcro sound, and then go back to your block and roll it up again. So you're going to do that several times. Once you feel like you have a nice even layer, you're going to put that onto another clean piece of paper. I like to just fold over my messy paper and use the outside. And you're going to take your paper that you're going to print onto, write your name and class code on it, and put it on top with your name showing. You have to have your name showing when you do printing like this, because that way you know that your name's on the right side. Then I'm going to put this into my little printing press I have and make sure the black is totally covered and press down really hard. If your black's not totally covered, just kind of scooch it down until you can press the whole thing. And then I'm going to peel off my paper, and there's my print. Now the first one I did is a little spotty in the middle. Sometimes that happens. So I'm going to do another copy. Now remember, a print is a copy. So keep in mind as we do this project that you are making a copy of what's on your block. And that's why it's called a print, because a print is a copy. So now I'm getting a little more ink on my brayer, rolling it out. I want to hear that Velcro sound. And then I'm going to put it on a clean piece, get my printing paper, name and class code on there with a pencil, not a Sharpie, put it on top, slide it into my printing press I have. And if you don't have a printing press, you can just rub it really hard with your hand, but then press down really hard. Stand up when you press down. You want to use all your back muscles. And pull it out, and that's it. Then you should have your prints. And you just keep making prints until you have some really, really good ones. Thank you, boys and girls.